Hello, I'm Tim, and this is a video about three instrument prototypes I developed. I will explain a bit about how they work and my motivation to build them. If you like, you can also check out my other video in which I perform a song with my instruments. Let's start with the Saberphone. The Saberphone is a hyper instrument, which means that it mechanically creates noise that is augmented by sensor data. Inside the Saberphone is a piezoelectric transducer that picks up sound created by four steel rods touching each other. The piezo is connected to a computer, together with an Arduino Nano that reads the Saberphone's spatial orientation and acceleration values from a digital gyroscope. This data is used to control how much distortion and reverb is added to the signal, and also to control a bandpass filter, and an optional Forman filter. The interface features light feedback, a button and a potentiometer. The collected data from the gyroscope and the interface is processed in Pure Data, a graphical open source multimedia programming environment that is free to download. The data arrives in Pure Data via the USB COM port and is then used to control several effects. The signal collected by the piezo transducer is then routed through those effects, of which I created some by myself, extracted some others from Jorn Eriksson's great Pure Data project Automationism, and included an overdrive written by Japanese blogger 139notfound. Let's carry on with the next instrument. The Flexarion is also connected to Pure Data, but while the Saberphone modulates mechanically created sound, the Flexarion synthesizes sound. Another difference is that the Flexarion does not use a gyroscope but a lot more potentiometers than the Saberphone. Four of them are connected by a flexible element which makes them all turn in the same direction when you move your hands. The mean sensor value of the potentiometers is then used to determine the main frequency for sound synthesis, while the individual sensor values are used to add sub-frequencies, which creates a more natural sound. It is also possible to deform the flexible connector, which does not affect the main frequency but results in greater deviation in the sub-frequencies. The remaining potentiometers are used to control distortion, reverb, and filter values, where the potentiometers for the filter are part of joystick controllers with attached pendulums. A force sensing resistor, which is actually another potentiometer, is used to control the volume of the instrument. Small buttons change the octave, and the scale. Initially, the instrument operates on an open sliding scale, but can be set to half and full step tones or several scales, like Dorian, Phrygian, and so on. Finally, this is the third prototype that combines features of the two previously shown concepts. I call the Roomstick a spatial polyphonic synthesizer because it synthesizes sound based on its orientation and acceleration in space. Two operation modes are available and can be switched by a button on the instrument. In mode 1, all three spatial axes control tones in different octaves, while in the second mode, one axis controls tones when they are set active. Like the Flexarion, the Roomstick uses several effects and can play in different scales. The shape is adapted from a broom because of its interesting mass distribution and performative potential. In an attempt to make the Roomstick wireless, I attached a Raspberry Pi running Pure Data to it and connected a Bluetooth transmitter. However, the Bluetooth solution created a quite long delay, so I started to look for alternatives. And this is what I found. Via radio frequency transceivers, I am now able to send spatial orientation data wirelessly. Basically all I need for one unit is a battery, a radio module, a gyroscope and an Arduino. And of course some electronic stuff to make it look sophisticated. Another advantage of the radio modules is their potential to create a network of instruments that can communicate with each other, which offers whole new opportunities. Another task is to redesign the interface to make it more user-friendly and intuitive. For example, capacitive touch sensing along the stick, we will see. The goal of this project is to create a digital open source instrument with unique physical behavior and responsiveness that encourages explorative play. You can see here and try the outcome at Lund University's group exhibition at Salone del Mobile in Milan, Italy, April 17th to 22nd, 2018. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and if you like, subscribe to my channel to be updated about this and my other projects. Thank you!